हेलो चिल्ड्रन, यू आर वेलकम टू डिजिटल क्लासेस ऑफ क्राइस्ट चर्च कॉन्वेंट हायर सेकेंडरी स्कूल गाडरवारा। दिस वीडियो इज़ फॉर क्लास 11th, सब्जेक्ट इज़ इकोनॉमिक्स, चैप्टर 4, चैलेंजेस बिफोर इंडियन इकोनॉमी। फर्स्ट टॉपिक ऑफ दिस वीडियो इज़ एग्रीकल्चरल मार्केटिंग। It means to exchange of agricultural commodities between farmers and traders, in which different stages are there, or you can say they are the procedures like gradation of crop, standardization of crop, collection and conservation, you know, unka protection karna, storage you can say. In India, the undermentioned system is privileged for the marketing of agricultural commodities. Where marketing is done? In villages, in mandis, through cooperative societies where government purchases crop and grains, government or street trading and retailers. What facilities are required for this? First is a storage facility, for which godowns and warehouses are required so that sufficient storage can be done. Otherwise, the crop and grain has a chance of rotting, सड़ जाएगा नहीं तो वो। Second is holding capacity. When crop is produced, then peasants are not in that state that they can hold that crop for longer time, because they need money for repaying and they cannot wait for favorable prices. So they are in the state of indebtedness, and they have to make the payments to saukars and bank loans. So they have to sell their crop at very low prices. Third is adequate and cheap transportation facilities. The prices of transportation facilities is higher, which makes the crops cost high, and peasants do not get sufficient price for their crop. Fourth is knowledge of market information. Which mandi is suitable and where the farmer can sell his produce, means what production he has made, or the product can be sold to which mandi to get highest price, about which farmers has to be given sufficient knowledge so that they can gain maximum profit. Absence of intermediators. When there is a channel or network of intermediators, then these bicholias, intermediate people, mediators, they take peasants' crop or grain at low prices and they sell at high prices. So if this channel of intermediates and network of mediators is broken, then agricultural marketing can be beneficial for the farmers. Next is defects of agricultural marketing in India. The first is poverty of cultivators. Cultivators are poor. They do not have sufficient fund. Soon after the production, they have to sell it into the market. Otherwise, they cannot make the payments, and then they cannot get sufficient price, actual price of their product. Second is again the same which you just explained, lack of adequate transportation facilities in rural areas. Roadways in rural areas is not in good state. Moreover, the means of transportations are scarce, so they cannot bring their product, their crop, to mandis or to the cooperative societies for sale, and they are selling it in their villages only to the mediators, and they are not getting favorable price or good prices of their grain. Lack of organization. The organization which can protect the rights of farmers, peasants, is not strong enough. If it is, then it is either regional or provincial. If a national organization which can protect and conserve the rights of peasants and can fight for them, so they can get maximum profit out of their product as well as from the government. Inadequate storage facilities. Number of godowns and warehouses are insufficient in localities. If they are, so they are accommodated by big intermediates and big traders, due to which farmers do not get sufficient place to store their crops in warehouses and godowns. So this problem is being faced by cultivators, and they have to make a haste in selling their product. Lack of government procurement system. Government also do not take a keen interest in taking in purchasing agricultural product. So all is being done in papers actually, and when moreover, the procedure of registration and selling of agricultural product is so complex, then the peasants get exhausted. So rather than selling to the marketing societies or in mandi or to the state government, they feel like to sell it a bit lower cost to the intermediates. So government must open more mandis and more cooperative societies so that peasants can get registered and can sell their agricultural product. Next is cooperative marketing. Cooperative marketing society is a voluntary organization set up for collection of the surplus produce of its members and others, processes it and sells it in the market or mandi. So there middlemen who exploit the farmers, they are kept away. When favorable prices is not received by the farmers, so marketing society can stock, and when the products the rate of products are good, so they can sell and they can pay the farmers the balance of the amount. So and a bit of profit which they receive in excess or in surplus, so by which they can pay to the staffs. So what are the advantages of cooperative marketing system? First, advantages to farmers, unko storage facilities provide ho jati hai easy. Reasonable prices they get of their produce. Free from exploitation by middlemen, because middlemen are not included in it. There is no networking or channel system. When produce is sold at large scale, so they become, they get better and higher prices. Impetus to farmers. Marketing societies inspire peasants to produce more and more because they get all the facilities from them. Increase in bargaining power because it can be held for a longer time and can be kept in godowns and warehouses. So peasants and societies can bargain for their product. Role in price fixation to attain favorable prices. Mass publicity becomes possible in case of cooperative marketing. Peasant can know about the marketing situation and they can understand at what time the prices are high and at what time they get lower prices. So they can know the trend of the business, trend of the market. And moreover, if peasants are in need of money, so marketing society can make finance by keeping their produce in their godowns and they can be financed so that they will get a financial assistance. Now, what advantages to the consumers? Availability of a standardized product, they get good quality product. Regular supply is possible throughout the year. Reasonable prices have to be paid by the consumers. And society also get benefited by better earning and development of mutual participation of the members and public. So this is all in this video. We shall discuss some more points related to agriculture and trade in next video. Thank you.